This is Match Game 74, production number 0130, air date to be announced, VTR 122373, take one. Get ready to match the stars. Greg Morris, Brett Summers, Maury Amsterdam, Juliette Mills, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there. Hi, John. Thank you. Are you ready?
I almost did my ballet dance there, but I changed my mind.
I go crazy when you get on your toes like that.
I have terrific turnout.
I know, I noticed.
Yes, you know, you have a definite ache for the ballet. It's kind of a ballet ache, I can tell from here.
Okay, shall we say hello to our current champion, Brenda Lee Merriweather. Brenda's won two games. She's got $700, and at the time expired last time, she was just about to have a go at the Big Money Super Match, right?
Right.
You ready for that?
Right.
All right, we'll have a go at it. You can win over $5,000, you know. We'll try that right after we try this.
Tune in, turn on, and blank out.
Okay, here we are. We're ready. Are you ready, Brenda?
I'm ready.
Okay. This is the Big Money Super Match, and I'll tell you how it goes. We polled a recent studio audience right here in this very building, and we got their best response to this. Blank worth, or blank worth. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you, Brenda Lee, if you match it. Second, $250. Third answer, $100. Which three celebrities would you like to get a little assist from here?
Brett.
Woolworth.
Woolworth. There's one.
Richard.
Fort Worth.
Fort Worth. Okay.
Juliet.
I can't think of a third one.
We'll give you a second or two. If you can't think of it, she'll just have to go with the two. Blank Worth. Okay.
Sorry.
So you've got Woolworth and Fort Worth. You may choose one of those two or think up one of your own. What would you like to do?
I think Money's Worth.
Money's Worth.
Money's Worth.
All right. You're abandoning Brett there and Richard, and you're choosing Money's Worth.
Okay, Brenda, I'll get you in the parking lot for that.
You're on your own, Brenda Lee, and let's find out if Money's Worth is up there. First, we'll reveal the $100 response. Fort Worth is up there, the one that Richard gave you. Here we go, we're climbing up the ladder now. Let's look for Money's Worth and see if it's under the $250 response. Woolworth is up there. That's the one Brett gave you. You've run out of answers from the celebrities, and now...
Oh, I hope it's Money's Worth.
Let's find out what is under the $500 response. Yeah! Money's Worth, your answer. Yeah. So that is $500 more for you. It puts you up to $1,200, and more important than that, it means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. Ping, ping, ping. Okay. You guys are drunk again over in the pinging department, aren't you? All right. Now, to collect the $5,000, you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. It has to be an exact match. Please choose one now.
I'm going to try Richard again.
Okay, Richard, you get ready to write. You face me if you please. Here is the $5,000 question. Musical blank. Richard is finished. Brenda Lee, how do you respond to this? Musical...
Chairs.
Musical chairs. You think she's right with musical chairs, I take it. That's why you're applauding. All right, we're all going to find out together right now as Richard Dawson reveals his answer. For $5,000, please, may we see it?
I feel so bad.
Why?
Okay. Now you got a total of
$6,200, Brenda Lee. Once you start there, I don't stop. And where is this? Well, they're all very happy for it. I can see that. And we're happy for it. We congratulate you. You're going to meet another player now and play another game. Are you ready? You think you're ready for that?
Yes.
Okay, let's all welcome Jerry Sobel. Hello, Jerry.
Hi, Gene. How are you?
Good. You want to have a seat up there? You know Jerry Sobel, Brenda Lee? He says congratulations. What do you got for me? A little oxygen?
Something like that.
Jerry, would you tell us a little bit about yourself, if you please?
Okay, I sell movies to hotels, and, no, legitimate.
Is that that funny place in the valley?
Legitimate. And I try to play as much golf and tennis as I can.
Golf and tennis?
Yes.
Okay, Jerry, welcome. Good luck to you. Brenda's had a lot of good luck. We wish you good luck too, Brenda. Now we'll push a button here, reveal the questions, ask Jerry to make a choice.
I'll try A.
He wants A. We're off and running again, folks. Rosalie wrote this poem to her husband. Please be careful. Please be neat. Don't drop ashes on my blank. It's a little poem, Fanny.
It's not really a poem. It's just a rhyme, Jane.
Well,
the difference.
Rhyming couplet.
Rhyming couplet.
Isn't it?
I love poetry. My favorite is little drops of water, little grains of sand. When they turn to gallstones, they hurt to beat the band.
Did you finish writing?
Oh, yeah, a long time.
Oh, I see. I didn't see your light up there. Fanny.
So it's hard for her to...
Oh, yes. All right, Jerry Sobel.
Hi.
Rosalie wrote the poem, down. Please be careful, please be neat. Don't drop ashes on my...
Seat.
Seat, he says. Okay. He says seat, Greg. May we see yours?
I don't think that's very nice, really.
Drop ashes on the seat?
No, drop ashes. Ladies' seat. You never do that. I said seat.
No, I wouldn't do that. He says seat. So there's one for you, Jerry. Brett?
What was it, dear? Rosalie said...
Please be careful.
You can't stand
neat.
The heat.
Don't drop ashes.
Don't drop ashes on my meat.
Okay. If you, all right. No, the saying goes, if you can't stand the heat, you got to stay out of the kitchen, is the way Harry Truman said it.
She used to walk around barefoot a lot, so she had to say feet.
Don't drop ashes on my feet. What'd you say, little girl?
That's me. I'm with Maury. Don't drop ashes on my
feet. The little girl said feet, right? What does the big boy over there say, Richard?
Well, she happened to be the lady dragon of the Ku Klux Klan. So she said, sheet.
Sheet. Okay.
There's a devil
that
under
KKK.
The sheet.
Yeah, all right.
Well, I thought I'd knock him publicly.
And now, Fanny, it's up to you.
Please don't drop ashes on my Fanny, but that doesn't rhyme, so I put seat.
Okay. So that's two for you, and we'll find out what's in store for you right after we find out about this message.
GSN presents...
Mark Goodson, I don't think he ever created a show, but he could take a bad idea and turn it into a good one. He could take a good idea and turn it into a blockbuster. He had that talent.
Stay tuned for more of That 70s Hour on GSN.
But he was a cheapskate. He never paid me, the bastard.
Here we go. We're going to carry on now and complete round one. Jerry scored two matches in his end of the round. Let's see how Brenda Lee does with hers. Sometimes, Pete and Gladys would stand on their heads and blank.
Now, you kids out there.
Yes. Pete and Gladys would stand on their... Sometimes, Pete and Gladys would stand on their heads and blank.
I'm up.
Shall I write a... Shall I write an answer for you?
I wish somebody would stand on their head.
I know exactly what you do. I've seen those postcards.
Get a hamburger for this lady. A
hamburger for her.
What
do you have?
I'll have a burger and fries.
You want burger and fries?
Burger and fries. Huckleberry
Dillon. You're all finished. Okay. All set. Sometimes Pete and Gladys, Brenda Lee, would stand on their heads and...
Kiss.
And kiss. I guess that's a good one. My first impulse was to say something like meditate. What did you say?
Stand on the heads and kiss?
Yeah. I said I can't be done.
Face schmear.
Kiss.
It can be done. So there's one. Brett?
I want you to see this one.
It's a good date.
Do you have a seven of diamonds?
No, I got a four of spades.
I wanted to give something brief because you were hustling me along and I couldn't think. They stand on their heads and spy.
And spy? Okay.
The worst thing I ever saw.
Yeah. That's...
He was right. They kiss.
All be winning.
Kiss, it is. That's two for you, Brenda Lee.
Okay, little girl.
Well, I'm with you, but you're not playing. Stand on their heads and meditate.
That's right. All right, you just stay with me. And, Richard?
And he'll have
you can kiss if you're
here.
Standing on your head. The only thing is your tongue keeps falling up your nose.
Sammy Flagg.
Well, they were real sweet people, and they just liked to talk, so they...
Okay. So that's three for you, Brenda Lee. Two for you, Jerry. We'll go to round two. Jerry, please make a selection.
I'll try A again.
All right, here it is.
Don't write, it says.
They're funny.
Now, let me
sides.
See. Greg doesn't play.
I do so play.
Fanny doesn't
play. Why don't I
Greg
play?
And Fanny are out of it, because you match in the first round. All right? Here we go. This is the second round. And final. Honolulu Lulu was arrested for blanking her grass skirt. Honolulu Lulu was arrested for blanking her grass skirt.
No, I'm not stuttering.
Honolulu Lulu. I didn't see your answer, little girl.
No, you didn't have to wait for this one.
Okay. They're all ready. So we'll get a response from Jerry Sobel. Honolulu Lulu was arrested for blanking her grass skirt. What do you say to
burning.
That? For burning yes. her grass skirt. Okay. Now, Brett, you are first. What do you
but
say?
She wasn't really arrested for burning her grass skirt. It was that she didn't have anything on underneath it that they arrested her. But I did say burning.
Well, you did indeed. Okay, Jerry, one for you. Maury?
I figured she had already burned her bra, so she burned her
burned
grass
her skirt.
Skirt.
That was a good answer, I guess. Okay.
Here
what do you say,
I am
Julia?
On my own again.
Yes, you are.
For plucking her grass skirt.
Oh, I see. Yes.
No, she no, dear, that's loves chickens.
Me. She loves me not. Loves me. Loves me not. Okay. I got the idea. Richard.
Present. Shortening.
Her shortening. Dress.
Until okay. it became dichondra.
All right, so that's it.
Nothing for you?
Fanny had matched the last time. Oh, wait a minute. Are we all? Yeah, we're all set. Okay, Brenda Lee, it's up to you now. You've got to match one celebrity to stay in the game. Two, however, will win the game for you. Here we go. Greg, Maury, and Richard do not participate. The men do not participate, only the ladies. Isn't that interesting? Never happened that way before. Mm-hmm. When the elevator stopped suddenly, Raquel's blank bounced on the floor. I think it is fortuitous. Only the ladies are participating in this. And all of the ladies are ready. Now, Brenda Lee.
Of course I'm finished.
Did you get... You're not finished?
Yes. Yeah.
Of course I'm finished.
Only the ladies have written answers. When the elevator stopped suddenly, Raquel's blank bounced on the floor.
I know this sounds silly, but her bosom...
It does sound silly to me, Brenda. I just can't picture it. I can't. All right. Now, ladies.
The silicone melted.
What did you say?
Well, of course it's... I mean, it's...
It's silly.
Well, it's ridiculous and almost impossible, but I was there, and her boss did all the bounce on the floor.
All right, the score is tied, 4-4. One more big bounce and you win the game, Brenda Lee. Let's see what you if you get a bounce out of Juliet Mills.
Yeah, you get a bounce out of me. Yeah, bust.
There it is.
You.
Win the game. Congratulations. What do we got there? Congratulations. $100. that was a pretty close game. We've got a gift for you, together with our thanks for being with us on Match Game 74. Jerry Sobel, ladies and gentlemen. Bye, Jerry. Okay, we'll get back to Brenda in a moment or so, but first we got this for you. Okay, this is the second time in one program that Brenda Lee Merriweather has been here, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, you feel cool about it now?
No.
All right, let's see how it goes, Brenda Lee. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Great blank. Now, the answer they gave most often, you know, is worth $500, $250, and $100. Now, which three celebrities would you like to get a little assist from here?
Maury,
how do you fill that blank in? Great blank.
Great Lakes.
Great Lakes, he says.
Brett?
How about Great Neck?
Great Neck.
It's in Long Island, I believe.
I know. We're in California.
Long Island. Well, you can at least sigh a little.
Okay. Great Neck is her answer. One more.
Great.
Greg, what do you say? Great
God.
I beg your pardon.
God.
Great God. Okay, so you've got Great God, Great Neck, and Great Lakes. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
Great Lakes.
Great Lakes is the answer that Maury gave, and that's the one she's looking for. Let's find out if it's up there at all, and if so, where. First, may we see the $100 response? Great Day is a good answer, isn't it? And you didn't think of it. Okay, we're still looking for Great Lakes. May we see the $250 response? Great Dane, another dandy one you didn't think of over there.
I think we all just had a terrible
last
time.
Chance, Brenda Lee, to find Great Lakes. Let's find out if it's under the $500 response. Great Scott. You know, none of those crossed my mind. Did you think of any of them?
Didn't think of any of those.
Yeah. I had Great Day.
You thought of Great Day.
Because I owned one at one
time. Oh, you did own a Great Day.
King Mark.
Well, it's easy to say it now.
You've added a little bit to your winnings here, Brenda Lee. You're up to $6,300. You're going to meet another player right now. Here comes Janet Iverson. Hello, Janet. Hi.
Hi.
You know Brenda Lee, Janet? Now, Janet Iverson is going to tell us a little bit about the story of her life.
Oh, yes.
Right?
Oh, I'm a native from Santa Monica, California. I've been married for 8.5 years, and we have 3 darling daughters.
Okay. I bet they are, darling, because you look like a darling lady. Don't you look like a darling lady?
Yeah.
She's a darling lady. All right, Janet. Challenger makes a selection, so it's up to you to give us your choice, A or B.
B, please.
Okay. Brand new game. Everybody plays. This is it, folks. Ralph said, Hilda's Donuts are so heavy, I used one of them as a blank. That's how heavy Hilda's Donuts are. Hilda's Donuts are so heavy, I used one of them as a blank. Now, this is a very easy one.
Of course it is.
Simple.
I didn't say
that's because you're not sitting up here.
Did I say
that's eight wrong answers I could give you right off the top of my head.
Give me eight.
All right. Now they're all ready. Janet, what do you say? Hilda's Donuts are so heavy, I used one of them as a...
paperweight.
Paperweight is a terrific answer. Terrific answer. Paperweight, doorstop, anchor, all kinds of great answers. What do you got there, Greg?
Oh.
None of those?
Tire.
not one of your better answers. Brett?
It's not one of your better answers?
No.
You don't think so?
No.
I think paperweight's a terrific answer. I wish I'd said it. I said tire.
That's two rotten answers in a row. And now, Maury?
Being a fisherman, I said a sinker.
A sinker. Oh, yeah, sinkers are called
hook,
donuts.
Line and that's sinker, remember?
Right, I got
sinker.
Okay, here we go. Juliet?
Hi. Well, I said wait.
Wait.
A weight, you know, a weight.
All right, they've matched that. Paperweight. Okay, there's one match. Richard?
It's very good.
Yeah?
Richard.
It's the first match you've had all week, but it's... well, that's good. I said a washer.
A washer. Oh, yeah.
Spacing.
A machine wash, yes.
Excuse me.
When you use a machine bolt.
I don't understand that.
Okay, that's enough. All right, he lost the bet, folks. Fanny Flagg.
Well, you see, somebody broke into his house, so he threw one at him, and he used it as a weapon.
A weapon.
Yes.
And caught a burglar that way. Time to eat that one, too. Chew it up there. Okay, so that you scored once there, and we'll see what you do. But first, we've got to see this and then hurry back. Just a few seconds to say goodbye, ladies. We'll look forward to seeing both of you next time, or we'll pick up in the middle of round one with a question for you, okay?
Right.
All right. Listen, you were all splendid.
Oh,
yeah, it's been a lovely day.
Oh, any credits that we'll look forward to seeing that show of yours? I hope that gets on.
May I say this to you?
Yes.
Thank you for giving me the opportunity to play the game with these marvelous people. I think they're great.
You had a good time, I tell you. Oh, that's marvelous. We enjoyed having you, Greg. We'll see you again sometime, right?
Right.
Terrific. Now, Brett, you've been trying to get a word in edgewise here all week, and I don't want to be unfair to you. And
what was I trying to say?
I don't know. You were trying to...
Was it about Adam and his appearance on The Odd Couple?
Probably. Is Adam appearing on The Odd Couple again?
No, only that once, but I keep saying it.
Oh, all right. Listen, I hope you will be able to join us next time for this galaxy of stars.
Joe Flynn, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Linda K. Henning, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
Thank you all. Team Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time.
Today's consolation prizes are Miromatic electric housewares, including bacon syrup casserole, electric broiler, and couple-minute percolator, fresh brewed coffee faster than instant from Miro, and a supply of Johnson's Future, the acrylic wall finish that gives you a tough acrylic shine that holds up. Future beautifully transparent, tougher than wax. And Rice-A-Roni, big flavor side dishes, so quick, so easy, saute and simmer to flavor perfection. Rice-A-Roni, the San Francisco treat. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. Stay tuned for Secret Storm next over most of these CBS stations.